Hey guys, Chris here from flippingcars.co.uk and welcome to another day in the life flipping, not cars, but vans. When people come on my course, I always say to them, have at least three cars on the go at any one time. And the reason's quite straightforward. You need one car that's retail ready, that's advertised and is on the market, ready for someone to come along and buy, give you the money and drive away. You need a second one that's near retail ready or is actually retail ready as well. So it could be in the body shop, it could be in the mechanics, but it's having its work done to it and it's near retail ready. And the third car is one that you've just either sold or is the one that you're currently sourcing ready to retail. So you've got a cycle of three cars on the go at any one time. And a fantastic tip here, guys, is get a fourth one in. And for the fourth one, have a van, have a commercial vehicle. It doesn't matter whether it's a crossover like a Hilux or something, or whether it's a van itself, and it could be something like a small van like a Berlingo or a Connect, or it could be a Vivaro or a Transit itself, but always have a commercial on the go as well. It's fantastic if you can offer that van, including VAT. There's a lot of people out there, small businesses that aren't that registered, lots of small builders, self-employed builders or plumbers. So if you can do it, including the VAT, you'll get a quicker sale. But people, when they're buying commercials, they do know that they're likely to have to pay VAT on the van that they're going to buy. When you come on my course, I also say to you that it's important that you do a video of any car that you've got up for sale. One of the biggest reasons people fail after my course, if they do go on to fail, is that they haven't done a video, haven't done good pictures of the car, so they don't get the inquiries that they expected. You've got to take a bit of time. It's not just a matter of going out and finding the car at the right price. You've got to show it well as well, so you've got to get good photos and you've got to get a good video. And this is even more important with vans. Now, the great thing about vans is it doesn't matter what the cosmetic condition looks like. It doesn't matter if it's got scuffs and scrapes. Vans have scuffs and scrapes. The most important things with a van are that it has a good MOT on it, it has some service history, if not a full service history, and that it's mechanically sound. People, when they come and look at vans, go over the vans in fine detail. They'll always look at the engine, they'll go right round it, they'll go underneath it, they'll have a good look at the, so it needs to be in good mechanical condition. And as I say, get a video of the van, walk around it, just film it. It doesn't matter if it's scruffy, whatever, but if you show the van and are honest with it, they can see that van from a distance. So every time I sell a commercial vehicle, it's normally to someone that's quite a long distance away from me, often over 100 miles. My last two vans I've sold to people in Wales, and I'm in Birmingham, and they've bought purely on the basis of the video that I've done. And here is a quick sample of what you can do for the video. It doesn't need to be professional. Just walk around with your iPhone or your smartphone and just film and talk over it. Here's a quick example. So if you've got three cars, get a van as well. If you haven't got your three cars, that's where you need to focus on to start with. But as soon as you've got your three cars and your flipping car business is going well, get a commercial vehicle. For sale is his 2012 Vauxhall Vivaro 2.9T 2 litre CDTI EF short wheelbase diesel manual. MOT until 24th of June 2017. Last service November 2015. The front's really good condition. Slight scuff to the front bumper. Few light marks to the bonnet. As you come round to the passenger side, there's a scuff to the front wheel arch with a slight dent, and there's a dent in the front passenger door with a scuff to the driver's side mirror. It needs a good valet inside, it's a bit scruffy. Staying into seats. Crack inside van on the inside with the shelving already in it. Small dent to the rear door, the side door, sorry. Good tread on the tyres. It's got the roof rack on the top. All good to the back. Cracking interior, really nice and clean. It's got the bars that can separate the back out as well for your storage. Plenty of shelving.
coming down the driver's side. There's a mark right down the centre. Good tread on the tyres all round. Bit scruffy on the inside. Nothing a good clean won't sort out.
A quick question for you guys. Have you ever bought and sold a van yourself? And if so, how quick did you sell that van? What was it? If you haven't bought or sold a van, what would you go out and buy? Leave a comment below. Tell me what type of van you'd buy. It'd be great to get some interaction between us all and sort of see what experiences we've all had with selling commercial vehicles. Have you sold crossovers like Toyota Hiluxes and that sort of thing? Let me know how the whole process went. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave me a comment below and why not subscribe to my YouTube channel. Check out some of my other videos and come across to my website flippingcars.co.uk, or in this case, flipping vans.